We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today the Church, the Manila Cathedral, celebrates the 66th anniversary of its dedication, when in 1958, after it was destroyed by the war, the new cathedral was dedicated and inaugurated. Any church, whether it is a parish church or a cathedral, is a reminder of God's presence with His people. When we look at the church, especially the cross on top of the bell tower, we are reminded that we are not alone. We have God with us. As we give thanks to the Lord for this gift of the Manila Cathedral, a very beautiful construction, a very beautiful place of worship, let us always be reminded, God is here. To make ourselves less unworthy of this Eucharistic celebration, let us humbly ask God's pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do,
through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Duwal kami sa Diyos sa kaitaasan, kaloob sa lupa ay kapayapaan. Minupuri ka, sinasamba ka dahil sa nakila mong kalwalhatian. Panginoon na dito sa hinang natin, amang nakapangyarihan. Panginoong Yeso Kristo, buktong nanak ng Diyos, kordero na naman. Oh,
Let us pray. O God, who year by year renew for us the day when this your holy temple was consecrated, hear the prayers of your people, and grant that in this place, for you, there may always be pure worship, and for us, fullness of redemption. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The angel brought me back to the entrance of the temple, and I saw water flowing out from beneath the threshold of the temple toward the east, for the facade of the temple was toward the east. The water flowed down from the southern side of the temple, south of the altar. He led me outside by the north gate and around to the outer gate facing the east, where I saw water trickling from the southern side. He said to me, "This water flows into the eastern district, down upon the Arabah, and empties into the sea, the salt waters, which it makes fresh. Wherever the river flows, every sort of living creature that can multiply shall live, and there shall be abundant fish. For wherever this water comes, the sea shall be made fresh. Along both banks of the river, fruit trees of every kind shall grow. Their leaves shall not fade, nor their fruit fail. Every month they shall bear fresh fruit, for they shall be watered by the flow from the sanctuary. Their fruit shall serve for food, and their leaves for medicine." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
God is our refuge and our strength, an ever-present help in distress. Therefore, we fear not, though the earth be shaken and mountains plunge into the depths of the sea.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
There is a stream whose runlets gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. God is in its midst. It shall not be disturbed. God will help it at the break of dawn.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
The Lord of hosts is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Jacob. Come, behold the deeds of the Lord, the astounding things he has wrought on earth.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, you are God's building. According to the grace of God given to me, like a wise master builder, I laid a foundation, and another is building upon it. But each one must be careful how he builds upon it, for no one can lay a foundation other than the one that is there, namely, Jesus Christ. Do you not know that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy that person. For the temple of God, which you are, is holy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
I have chosen and sanctified this house, says the Lord, that my name may remain in it for all time.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Since the Passover of the Jews was near, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. He found in the temple area those who sold oxen, sheep, and doves, as well as the money changers seated there. He made a whip out of cords and drove them all out of the temple area with the sheep and oxen, and spilled the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. And to those who sold doves, he said, "Take them out of here and stop making my Father's house as a marketplace." His disciples recalled the words of Scripture, "Zeal for your house will consume me." At this, the Jews answered and said to him, "What sign can you show us for doing this?" Jesus answered and said to them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." The Jews said, "This temple has been under construction for 46 years, and you will raise it up in 3 days?" But he was speaking about the temple of his body. Therefore, when he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they came to believe the Scripture and the word Jesus had spoken. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, the cleansing of the temple, the story which we have just heard, is narrated by all the four Gospels. It means that you can see the same story, although on different places, in the Gospel of Mark, Luke, Matthew, and John. So if the four gospel writers included the cleansing of the temple in their gospel, the story must be very important. The message must be very important. And therefore, the question is, what is the message? What does the story tell us? Well, there are several things, but I'll just give you one, two. I'll give you two. Number one, the more important one is that the destruction of the temple, when the cleansing of the temple, when the Jews asked them, "What sign can you show us for doing this? Anong karapatan mong gawin ang ginawa mo?" And Jesus answered, destroyed this temple, and in 3 days, I will raise it up. Gulat yung mga Hudyo. Wow, yabang ha, no? Ginawa ito sa loob ng 46 na taon. Almost 50 years. At itatayo mo lang sa tatlong araw, sa loob ng tatlong araw. Yabang ha, no? But what is the point? The point is, Jesus is referring to himself as the new temple. Once he has risen from the dead, the people will no longer worship at the temple made by stones, but rather worship in the temple made by his resurrected body, glorious body. So it's kind of a shift, no? Paglipat mula sa templong gawa sa bato tungo sa pagsamba sa templong ng katawan ni Jesus na muling nabuhay. In other words, with the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, with his resurrection, Jesus is somehow making the temple of Jerusalem irrelevant. Of course, the Jews would not accept that. But that, as among us Christians, that is the reality. With the resurrection of Jesus, we are no longer worshiping the temple of Jerusalem. We are worshiping the temple of the risen body of Christ. That's the first important reason. The second reason that I would like to give you is Jesus is reminding the people who have made the temple a marketplace the purpose of the temple. And it is a place of worship because it is the house of God. Sabi nga ng Panginoon, Stop making my Father's house a marketplace. Ang templo itinayo hindi para maging palengke. Kasi sa halabas ng templo kung saan dumadaan ang mga tao para sumamba, nandoon ang lahat ng mga tindero at tindera. Nagbebenta ng mga hayop na iaalay sa templo, nagbebenta ng mga kalapati na iaalay sa templo, merong money changer sapagkat yung ordinary money, no, cannot be used as an offering to the temple. Parang siguro dito, no, pag naghulog kayo sa kolekta, karamihan inuhulog ninyo ay piso, yung pera ng Pilipinas, yung ating currency. Maganda siguro gawin ko, i-require ko ang lahat ng collection dapat i-convert sa dollar, no? Okay. Kaya meron tayo money changer sa labas. Hindi tatanggapin ang Philippine currency. But that was the practice in the temple during the time of Jesus. That's why a poor man, a poor Jew who comes from, say, Nazareth, no, or far-flung area, will go to Jerusalem once a year, bringing with him his money, and he will look for money changer because he cannot put in the collection box his own money. He has to convert it into the temple money, and doon nagkakaroon ng lamangan. Doon nagkakaroon ng injustice. Kasi dahil wala kayong choice, ito ang conversion rate. Susunod kayo, ayaw nyo o gusto nyo. Kaya yung taong pobre na ito lang ang makakaya, kung kulang ang kanyang pera, hindi siya makapag-aalay kasi hindi niya pwedeng ihulog yung kanyang pera. It has to be converted to the temple currency. Doon nagagalit ang Panginoon. Yung templo na dapat ay gamitin sa pagsamba ay nagiging lugar kung saan ang mga tao ay napipigilang sumamba. Stop making my Father's house a marketplace. Perhaps at this point, my dear brothers and sisters, I invite you to ask yourselves, what precious things have been converted into cheap ones? What things that are divine have been converted into something that is too secular? Ano yung ipinagpalit natin sa mga cheap na bagay? I can give you some. Manners. Manners. Good manners. Nung araw, ang bata marunong mamupo. Marunong magmano. Ngayon, sasabihin mo pa, magmano ka dyan, matanda yan sa'yo. Hindi kusa. Oh, paano ka sumagot? Mamupo ka. Nawala na yon. Something precious that we have handed over to us through generations of Filipinos have been lost little by little. Behavior, manners. I saw a picture of Manila, I think before the war, and it's I think in Santa Cruz or Divisoria, and people were properly dressed kahit na naglalakad sa kalsada. Ang galing, ang ganda. Ngayon, kumisan, kahit sa pagsimba, parang nanggaling sa, parang kagigising lang. You know, ito, hindi biro to ha. Last year, simbang gabi, madaling araw, 4:30. So, nagbigay ako ng communion, napunta ako sa gitna, and then bumalik ako. May nakita ko nagsimba, naka-pair of pajamas. Hindi ko alam kung bago yun, ano? Sinimba niya yung kanyang bagong pair of pajamas. Sabi ko, ano ba to? Galing ba to sa higaan at dumiretso na sa simbahan? Nawawala na ba tayo ng sense of divine? Na iba yung damit natin kapag tayo ay sumasamba, nagmimisa, dumadalo sa pagdiriwang ng misa? Minsan sasabihin ako, masyado naman mahigpit ang simbahan, no? Hindi ba ako papansinin ng Diyos kung hindi ako masyadong ano? Eh, yun ang kumisan, maling ano eh. We have lost that. Things that we value before and now have become cheap. Kaya tuloy kumisan, yung mali na nangyayari, hindi na natin pinapansin kasi naging karaniwan na. Pag nanakaw sa gobyerno, umaangal pa ba tayo? Katiwalian sa gobyerno, nagre-reklamo pa ba tayo? Katiwalian nga na iba, eh, pare-pareho lang naman yan eh. Yun ang mali. Stop making what is precious to something cheap. Just like Jesus saying, do not turn the house of my Father into a cheap marketplace. It was built for the Lord. Use it to worship the Lord. As we celebrate the anniversary of the dedication of this cathedral, let us thank the Lord for this gift of beautiful church. But no matter how beautiful this church, this cathedral is, if there is no living community worshiping inside, it will just be a beautiful cathedral to look at. Hindi itinayo ang cathedral para pagmasdan at hangaan, kundi para gawing lugar ng pagsamba. Huwag nating gawing cheap ang isang mahalagang regalo. Amen.
Please stand.
Together we profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
As we celebrate the dedication of our Mother Church, the Manila Cathedral, let us bring our prayers to the Father who had called us to be living stones in our great need. Let us say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Church in every place will offer worthy and reverent worship. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all gathered by God in this church may find grace and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who care for the sacristy, the maintenance and cleaning of this church, will persevere in their service. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may always revere and respect every sanctuary of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the generous support of our benefactors may find their reward in the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the departed may enjoy the eternal light and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Holy Lord and Father, as we celebrate the anniversary of the dedication of this cathedral, grant the petitions of the community you have gathered here once more at the altar. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Recalling the day when you were pleased to fill your house with glory and holiness, O Lord, we pray that you may make of us a sacrificial offering always acceptable to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in this visible house that you have let us build, and where you never cease to show favor to the family on pilgrimage to you in this place, you wonderfully manifest and accomplish the mystery of your communion with us. Here, you build up for yourself the temple that we are, and cause your church spread throughout the world to grow ever more and more as the Lord's own body, till she reaches her fullness in the vision of peace, the heavenly city of Jerusalem. And so, with the countless ranks of the blessed in the temple of your glory, we praise you, we bless you, and proclaim your good greatness as we acclaim.
Santo, 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 Panginoong Diyos na mga upo, napupuno ang langit at lupa ng kadakilaan mo. Hosanna, Hosanna sa kaitaasan. Hosanna, Hosanna sa kaitaasan. Pinagpala ang paririto sa ngalan ng Panginoon. Hosanna, Hosanna sa kaitaasan. Hosanna, Hosanna sa kaitaasan. Hosanna, Hosanna sa kaitaasan. Hosanna, Hosanna sa kaitaasan.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. May the people consecrated to you, O Lord, we pray, receive the fruits and joy of your blessing, that the festive homage they have offered you today in the body may redound upon them as a spiritual gift through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In celebration of the anniversary of the dedication of the Manila Cathedral, I will give you access to the altar table so that if you wish, you may kiss or just touch it with your hand as a sign of veneration and respect. So you will form a single line to your right, then pass through that small gate, go up, be careful, no? And then pass by here, kiss, and then you go down to that little gate also to your left after the Mass. And Simbang Gabi will begin this Sunday at 8 p.m. for the evening Masses. And at dawn, the Mass will be at 4:30 beginning December 16. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, the Lord of heaven and earth, who has gathered you today in memory of the dedication of this church, make you abound in heavenly blessings.
Amen.
And may he who has willed that all his scattered children be gathered together in his Son, grant that you may become his temple and the dwelling place of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thus may you be made thoroughly clean, so that God may dwell within you, and you may possess with all the saints the inheritance of eternal happiness.
Amen.
And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.